Hey everybody, it's Invicta, and I want to make this quick video in regards to an upcoming balance update that's going to be hitting for the week of May 1st. First off, thank you everyone who did come by for my birthday 24-hour stream. I do appreciate it. Secondly, let's hop onto this balance update. As always with these news videos, you can find a direct link down below going straight to the article and the official post from Blizzard talking about said news. And this one is going to be somewhat of a short one, but I'm going to be giving you a little bit of insight as far as what my opinions are about this theme of Blizzard nerfing brand new heroes. And I think it comes with no surprise to anyone that they're looking at Tracer, who literally was released last week, and there's some changes, let's put it that way. So I'm not going to allude to anything. Let me just hop right on into this change here for the balance update coming later on this week for Tracer. Blizzard says, we are planning to release a new balance update for Heroes of the Storm on Wednesday, May 4th, in order to apply a few balance changes. Read on for complete list of changes, blah, 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 blah. You can see that in the info box below. Now, specifically talking about Tracer. Tracer's health has been decreased slightly. This is going to be her base health, as well as her health regeneration has also decreased slightly. Her basic attack damage has been reduced by 2. Some people may think that that's not a big deal. Some people might feel that that's a big deal because they are changing the way that the base value is set to, from 29 to 27. But the scaling, of course, remains the same. As I said in the last news video that you saw, 4 years of the Storm, Blizzard would have to do something completely major in order to change the actual scaling of said abilities or damage, but within Tracer's case, all they did was they simply lowered her base damage for the attack damage, the base attack damage, down from 29 to 27. It's not that big of a change, but it will be far-reaching upon the later levels of a game, depending on which talent tiers you go, obviously. Locked and loaded, this has been increased. The damage bonus has been increased from 35 to 40%. Pretty nice little buff there, but again, I think that is in direct counter to the basic attack damage that was reduced. Not that big of a deal, in my opinion. Melee, the Pulse Strike talent, Pulse Bomb Charge bonus has increased from 15 to 20%, which is also a pretty nice little buff there. Recall, the cooldown has increased from 24 to 26 seconds. Slipstream, the cooldown reduction has been reduced from 4 seconds to 2 seconds, meaning that that is a nerf. That is not a buff, that is a nerf. So, what does Blizzard have to say about Tracer? Well, let's hop on into it, and then I'll give you my overall thoughts about this balance patch coming up later on this week, actually, at the time it's recording, day after tomorrow. Blizzard says, as we're sure many of you have noticed, Tracer's performing just a little too well on all fronts. We are excited to bring her to the Nexus. We understand that in the right hands, she can be an absolute terror to the enemy team. We're lowering her health, basic attack damage, and increasing Recall's cooldown to make her less universally powerful. We're going to be giving back some of that basic attack damage on her level 16 talent tier to further separate sleight of hand from the other options, which should help the choice between more pulse bomb charges versus stronger basic attacks feel like a more meaningful decision. We also saw an opportunity to help improve our talent pick rate, so we're making minor adjustments to Pulse Strike and Slipstream. We'll continue to keep a close eye on her, as we believe she is similar to Illidan, where the right place from a balance perspective is more narrow than most of our other heroes. So, it's interesting that they bring up the Illidan comparison, because I don't draw any comparisons to Illidan at all for Tracer. Tracer has more options for not only for escaping, but also getting in, dishing out damage, and then getting out, all tied to her kit. Illidan does not technically have something like that. Unless if you talk about friend or foe for the talent that gives him the ability to dive to allies, he still cannot use that. He can't use that arbitrarily. He has to have something to jump to. It's more specifically, he has to be able to jump to his allies with friend or foe. So I was curious as to why Blizzard made the Illidan comparison here. I understand what they're talking about. They don't want to use this Invicta term, obviously, of the finesse hero. But Tracer certainly is. Illidan, of course, certainly is. And I guess in that regard, yeah, they are kind of similar. But make no mistake about it, Tracer and Illidan have nothing to do with each other other than that little similarity, and that's it. There's no inherent intertwining that they both kind of overlap with their playstyle or their moves or anything like that, as everyone probably is aware. Now, talking about this trend of Blizzard going back and nerfing brand new heroes, a lot of people seem to feel that this is kind of like a cash grab sort of ploy where, oh, they're just going to give us a super powerful hero right off the bat, and then of course they're just going to nerf it because after everyone buys the character or they pre-order Overwatch, blah blah blah, then of course they're just going to nerf it. The trend speaks to reinforce that argument, but I strongly disagree, and I don't believe that Blizzard does stuff like that. It's undeniable that Li Ming was probably the most powerful hero that has ever been released by Blizzard from opening week and on, and she's still extremely powerful. Yes, she's gone through some nerfs, and yes, it was a very, very quick turnaround. We saw the same thing with Zul. We saw the same thing with the Butcher. We're going to see the same thing with Tracer. Kael'thas admittedly did not really have that. He had a while there before he actually was touched as far as the nerf bat is concerned, pretty heavily and extensively. But Tracer, this is about a week or turnaround from when she was out, and not including the people who did not own her via the pre-order bonus for the Origins edition of Overwatch. But you know what I mean. This is a very, very quick turnaround again. And this whole trend about Blizzard doing this sort of thing, I think it is relevant. I think that it is important that they understand where the problems are. The only thing that I would say is that I would prefer, this is just my take on this. I'd prefer to be able to test out the changes on, like, say, a PTR, especially when it comes to balance changes. Now, I understand, and I'm not calling for Blizzard to step up and say, hey, Blizzard, we need a PTR patch for every balance patch. I'm not saying that, because quite frankly, that's a little bit unreasonable to expect from a company. But I think that when new heroes come out and they get a quick turnaround nerf bat, it's not really fair to say that, oh, well, they were just wanting to give us an overpowered hero to get our money, and then that's that. Again, I understand that the contrary has been reinforced by this current trend of Blizzard doing said things, but I can almost guarantee you that's not the case. Generally speaking, whenever a new hero comes out, they do tend to be pretty powerful because, A, and you can think of it across not even just Blizzard games, any game. Whenever anything new is introduced to a video game, it always seems powerful, more powerful than it actually really is. It's a little bit of a smokescreen because of the simple fact that no one knows how to play against her, no one knows what her counters are, no one knows exactly how well she can perform at the highest levels, that sort of thing. It's just feeling out. You're taking your first step into the pool, and you're not sure if you're in the deep end or not yet. And when you get there, you realize, oh my goodness, this is way, way powerful. This is either awesome or, oh, this is broken. And again, it's natural to do that stuff in any video game, not just Heroes of the Storm. I can't say that I'm a huge fan of these big turnarounds. I think that maybe a little bit more time should go into possibly testing these before they're released, or possibly letting us have a week of testing on the PTR with a brand new hero for balance changes before they come out, stuff like that, adjustment. And again, I should mention that I'm completely ignorant to how involved any sort of scripting goes, any sort of changes to the engine, any sort of balance changes. I don't know anything about that. All I can do is simply commentate on what we have seen and how it plays in the game. Me personally, I don't really feel that Tracer was that powerful, at least not that broken anyway. Do I think that these nerfs hit her a little bit harder than they should? No. Honestly, the adjusted values, that probably feels pretty appropriate. The only thing that really Tracer, and specifically talking about Tracer, is that her biggest strength, of course, is her going to be her mobility. And if Blizzard starts nerfing her mobility, they might as well just start trying to remake the character, I guess. Like that's kind of like saying, well, Malfurion, he doesn't get heals over time anymore, or Arthas doesn't get the ability to use Frostmourne anymore, so something like that. With Tracer, it's all about mobility. I mean, outside of melee, you've got her basic attacks that she can do for it while strafing. She's got the pulse strike. The pulse bomb, rather. She has recall, of course, and she also has blink. I think blink is probably the biggest thing that people are going to have to really take a look at, because that, in my opinion, I think recall is a great item. I think a great ability. I think that melee is a great ability. I think pulse bomb is a great ability. I don't know if the answer is possibly, well, let's nerf the cooldowns of recall, one of her staples in her kit, versus saying, like, hey, maybe we shouldn't give her the pulse bomb at level 1. I know that's what makes her unique, but I'm just trying to think outside the ideas. I'm not suggesting anything. I'm arbitrarily bringing up hypothetical scenarios that could possibly be a better option instead of just quickly turning around and nerfing something right off the bat. So, again, I'm on record saying that I think that these changes are fine with Blizzard. It is a little bit disturbing that we keep seeing this trend of brand new heroes coming out and then get immediately nerfed like a week later. And no, I don't believe that Blizzard is doing it with any sort of financial backing. I realize that that seems like I'm in the minority on that, but I honestly do not truly believe that that is the case. So what do you think about Tracer? Do you think I'm right? Do you think I'm wrong? Do you think that Blizzard should be waiting? Do you think they should be testing it more? Do you think that they should be kind of letting balance updates kind of fade by the wayside for a couple weeks or two before looking at a new hero? Let me know what you think. As always, you can check the link down below in the description. Thank you to all the new subscribers. Thank you all as well for the birthday wishes. I do appreciate it. And of course, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!